Mastercam 2018 introduces changes that streamline your programming workflow for mill 3D high-speed toolpaths. You will enjoy greater flexibility and control when defining which geometry to machine and which geometry to avoid. For each geometry group you create, you can assign variable stock-to-leave values on its walls and floors. The first thing you will notice when you select any of Mastercam's 3D high-speed surface roughing or finishing toolpaths is that the Toolpath Surface Selection dialog does not display. Instead, the Toolpath dialog immediately opens and the new Model Geometry page displays. It is important to note that all of the geometry selection options are now on the Model Geometry and Toolpath Control pages. The Toolpath Control page consolidates options that used to be on the Toolpath Type and Tool Containment pages. Notice that Tool Containment has been removed from the list of pages. The two grids on the Model Geometry page make it possible for you to set up variable stock-to-leave values on walls and floors. You can now create as many separate groups of machining geometry and avoidance geometry as you need, each with their own set of stock-to-leave values. The grid names reflect a change in terminology for Mastercam 2018 3D high-speed toolpaths. Drive has become machining, and check has become avoidance. Machining and avoidance are terms already used in other Mastercam toolpath types and are more common in the industry. Mastercam automatically creates one machining geometry group and one avoidance geometry group with no entities. When you get to this page, you start selecting geometry. In the graphics window, you will notice that the model geometry has changed to white. Display remainder is active and using the default color. So any white geometry you see has not been selected for this toolpath. The group and remainder colors display only when you are working in the model geometry page. If you move away from the page, the original colors assigned to the model return. You select entities beneath the machining geometry grid to begin assigning geometry to the group. With Mastercam 2018, you can now use window selection to quickly pick solid faces, surfaces, and STL entities. The selected entities now display in your defined group color. For each group created, you pick entities, assign a group name and color, and stock delete values. You can do this in any order. To create a new machining group, click Add New Group. Enter a unique name and color to easily distinguish this group from the previous group. We want to leave 0.25 inch of stock on the walls and floors of this group. Double-click in each field to enter a value. To pick the geometry for this new machining group, make sure the row is selected in the grid and click Select Entities. Use the same techniques you have already seen to pick some geometry to avoid. Now we will refine the tool motion by selecting containment boundaries. Let us backplot the toolpath to see our results. For the first machining group, Mastercam leaves no stock. For the second group, you can see that stock has been left.